Hi, I'm Oscar van Deventer, and this is the Sloppy Cube. You have seen the Sloppy Cube before on my YouTube channel, but what's special about this version, or this, is that I printed them myself on my own 3D printer. So, when I got my 3D printer, of course, I wanted to try out what's possible, and one of the things that I wanted to know is, can I print a twisty puzzle on my 3D printer? How difficult is it? What problems do I encounter? So I've done a lot of prototyping, trying different approaches, and here is the result. One of the approaches that I tried was splitting the pieces in two and then use little screws to screw them together. And the whole reason for this is that when you have parts hanging in the air, then it doesn't look that good. So and also support material. So I wanted to try and print it without support. So this part is in two halves, and each of the halves is printed flat. Then you put them together and you put in the little screws. Well, I was not entirely pleased because the bottoms are never flat. As you can see, there is quite a big crevice in between. So another approach that I tried is doing the split in the other direction, not in this direction, but in that direction. And now I have more space for the screws, so I can screw them more tightly. But still what you're seeing here is a little crevice, so it looks a bit better, but still far from perfect. Yet another approach that I did was just taking a piece as a whole and printing it like this with support material, and then having solid pieces and then removing all the support material. And actually that is what you're seeing here. And what you may notice is that all of these parts, they have sort of flat edges, because it was on these edges that the piece was put down, and there is support material under it. By the way, I hadn't explained to you yet what makes the floppy cube so special, or the sloppy cube. It looks sloppy, but it's actually highly accurate. All the faces are the same. It looks a bit like a Rubik's cube. And you know, for a Rubik's cube, it's easy to scramble it and hard to solve it. But actually this one is very hard to scramble. So if you give it to a friend, your friend will probably not be able to scramble it. And of course, once scrambled, almost nobody can solve it. It's really hard to scramble, and it's extremely hard to solve. Anyway, the question that I wanted to ask you, well, first of all, of course, is can you print it yourself? I have a link for the design with the description, so I hope you will try it. But you've seen the different approaches to making these parts, with the screws, without screws, in different directions. And which approach do you like best? And also, what do you think of the looks of this puzzle compared to other puzzles of mine that you have seen? Thank you for watching.